No matter how much we try, we cannot recover alone. And that being said, one of the people that I went through my initial recovery process with when I got here to Texas is a good friend of mine named Patrick. He has requested the Alien by Manchester Orchestra, but he's also given me a dedication of sorts to apply to this video in as a way to kind of preface it for this channel. So Patrick stated, as someone intimately acquainted with self-sabotage, this song is my dedication to the channel. It's about the moments when your life gets derailed and the connections made along the way. From an outside perspective, it's not always apparent what causes someone to become unhinged. And from an inside perspective, it's not always apparent just how much collateral damage your own actions can cause. With that said, I present The Alien by Manchester Orchestra, and the original link will be in the description. I hope you all are having a good day, and if you're not, thank you for being here, and I hope you enjoy the song.
The lights were low enough, you guessed. You swapped your conscience with your father's medication. Limped from Rome to Lawrenceville, and on the way wrote out a self-made declaration. When you got to Pleasant Hill, you forced the traffic to erase your family demons. Made a pact with you and God, if you don't move, I swear to you, I'm gonna make you.
So just the first verse. Swapping conscience with father's medication, for instance. When we don't want to address or experience our feelings in addiction, especially, we coat them with whatever substance we prefer so that we don't have to experience them. Going from one place to another, as he says, from Rome to Lawrenceville, for me, when I moved here from Arizona, there was a great deal of trepidation and anxiety. I was at odds with myself because I knew that where I was at wasn't going to help me, but I didn't know that where I was going was going to be any different or any better. And I just had to push the part of myself that didn't want to go to take the chance. So let's keep going. But I really like this so far. The high
school's letting out. All the kids saying the same thing that they used to.
In the song that Bloodywood did about bullying and finding out that the kid that he bullied became the paramedic that saved his father's life, this is the almost the reverse of that. Still a first responder, but I know for me that the bullies that I had as a kid are still living where I left them, still doing nothing, and it's been 25 years. There's a cognitive dissonance when you recognize a bully, whether it's your bully or a family member's bully, in a role that is meant to be helpful. So what he's experiencing here, from what I can understand, is the cognitive dissonance of recognizing the bully for who he was, but also the role that he's moved into and become. So there is that tinge of guilt, but then there's also the need to accept that assistance too. So I can understand the struggle there. It's definitely not easy. I know when I went back to visit at one point, I had to face my bullies, and they treated me the same way they did in high school, but I had gotten older and maybe a little bit wiser, and they hadn't. I just want to point out that I like the subdued nature of the music. It's very beautiful, but it's also very subtle, and it doesn't overpower the message of the song. And I know groups like 21 Pilots, for instance, are very good at that as well, where they'll bring the music in where the music needs to be, but then they'll back it out enough so that the impact of the lyrics is there as well.
Hospital food, there's never enough medication. The doctor asks about your ears. You said your mom said you were made from a revelation. Revelation never scares. Your fear came from a drunken dad, a pair of scissors.
So it almost sounds like the person that he's talking about was maybe a surprise or an unexpected blessing. And then we're compounding the bullying with the drunken father. So all this kid's life, it seems, has been nothing more than this fear, overwhelming fear, bullies and parents and now the part where he says, were you just finally letting go? Did you mean to take out all those people with you? There's, of course, the literal, especially in today's day and age, unfortunately, with so many unnecessary school shootings. But I think this goes deeper. I think this is recognizing that self-harm doesn't just affect us. It's a final out for the person, but the people that live on with the memory of that person and the I'm trying not to trigger YouTube. I think that it has a longer lasting impact on those around us than we realize. And I will leave it at that. So there's a literal translation there, but I truly believe that he means this in a much more emotionally impactful way. I don't want to have to pause as often, but I'm trying to do this between verses so that I don't have to keep going back and re-editing the video, because I try to do this with no cuts or anything, but sometimes YouTube just, yeah. So again, I know I've been in some pretty dark places, mentally, physically, emotionally, and I've pushed away people that meant well in favor of people that didn't. Or I've isolated to the point where the people that did care didn't know how to react or respond anymore, because they felt like no matter what they did, it never got through to me. And this really hits home where you're saying, I didn't mean to, because We don't. In the midst of our addiction, in the midst of our depression, in the midst of our anxiety, our isolation, we're not doing it to push people away. It's almost like we're sheltering ourselves. And I know that there were times where a week would go by and I wouldn't even notice that that much time had passed. Or, you know, there were times that I'd been awake for a week that it didn't even feel like it until I finally hit that point where I had to sleep. And then I realized, oh man. And then I'd look at my phone and realized I had like 30 or 40 missed calls. And I get it. I didn't mean to. I did not shut you out, any of you out, intentionally. None of us do. It's a protection measure. There's elements of guilt and doubt and self-sabotage. And at my lowest, I didn't want people to see me that way or hear me that way, because in retrospect, that wasn't me. So let's wrap this up. I apologize for getting so long-winded, guys. We all go out alone. Just, the choice is yours. But I want you to know that if you need to talk, if you're feeling alone, if you're feeling lost, reach out to me on Instagram. Reach out to me in the comments. I do my best to respond to everyone. I really, truly appreciate you guys. And when I say I love you, and that you're not alone, and that I care, I mean it. Don't be afraid to reach out to me. I know it's hard, especially when we're at our most vulnerable. It's when it's the hardest. Don't be afraid to reach out. I've been there. So, anyway. Thank you, Patrick. This is a great song. I absolutely love the meaning in the music. And I hope I did the song justice. So thank you all for being here. I love you. I care. And you're not alone. Till next time.